Peter Johnson at RealAgriculture.com, and we're here going to start our Real Dream Workshop series. I love it. So what we're going to do is we're going to tour Ontario and we're going to find shops with cool little things to them or big things, things people have thought of that you might well want to put in your shop. So I'm here with Shawn Schill, Shawrid Farms here at Arthur. And Shawn, this is an absolutely amazing shop. You can drive right through this shop from one end to the other, in that end, out that end. Unbelievable. I love this shop. I want this shop on my farm, Shawn. So by the way, Shawn, don't forget, Shawn is one of our real wheat growers. I just can't get over 154 bushel per acre wheat. So not only does Shawn have an awesome shop, he's a great wheat grower as well. Shawn, you built this shop, what did you say, 5 years ago?
5 years ago, yeah.
Okay, so it's got some great features, but some from a building a new shop perspective, what would you tell growers? Where are you gonna go?
I would tell them to look at what they're thinking that their needs are right now, but you need to look down the road and you need to think about what your future needs are gonna be. This is a 60 by 120 shop, and quite honestly, when we built the shop, it looked big. It was big to us, but by the time we tooled it up and we got everybody in here and everything else, the shop became small. And we have outgrown the shop within 5 years, and it's, we're actually considering expanding at this point just based on the fact that we hardly have enough floor space anymore.
Yep, awesome. So your comment to me before was, whatever you think you're gonna spend, what do?
Double it.
And however big you think it should be, what do?
Double it.
So there's rule number one. When you start think big, because, and it's amazing how common that thought process is. So a few other things about this shop, right, Shawn? You mentioned that the air compressor and the high pressure washer, if you do build on, or if you make another shop, what would you do differently there?
So we had all our utilities inside the shop, air compressor, pressure washer, all that stuff. And what it creates is a lot of noise in the shop. And actually, if I was doing it again, I would certainly take all that, those motors, those compressors and all that stuff, and I would move them outside into their own isolated area where they can't, and then make the shop quieter, because the shop does get fairly loud, just the acoustics and everything else. And when you have all that stuff running, it makes for a bit of a dreary day because you're always listening to the stuff pounding away.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think that's awesome. That makes more comfortable for your employees. I do love this drive-through. I really do that. And you said heated flooring as well. And that's, I think, fairly standard now, but certainly another thing that just is creature comfort, right? We're creatures comfort. Yep. So behind us here, we have the parts storage.
Yes.
And you say that just simply isn't enough.
We built, this was our main storage back here, and we have since doubled that part storage, and we are out of part storage room again. So it seems that over the years, you just collect more knickknacks or things that you want to keep because you just might use them someday, but that all adds up.
Yep.
And so if we do decide to expand, we'll actually be looking at a separate part of the building that is dedicated solely to parts, and it'll be, you know, much bigger than what we got.
Yeah, so we started here, we built the mezzanine, and now we're gonna build a dedicated parts area, and organization pretty key as well, right?
Organization is key. A shop can get itself pretty loosey-goosey, I use a term around here with my guys, and you lose a lot of space when stuff isn't organized well, and that's what I tell my guys, we gotta make sure we keep organized or things are just gonna get more and more crowded as time marches on.
Oh yeah, you should just come to my shop, baby. I have all sorts of spare parts, but I'll be doggone if I know where they are. It's just brutal. So the last thing, Shawn, is you've got all your oil on wheels. I think that's kind of cool. You can pull it to whatever piece of equipment, but you're not as happy with that as you thought you would be.
When the tanks are loaded, they actually are fairly heavy. So if you have a piece of equipment that's on the far end of the shop, you end up dragging. It takes like two guys to get that moved all down there. And if you want to do something on your own, it's they're fairly heavy. So, you know, if I was doing it again, I would look at dedicated outdoor storage for our oil and those products, and then look at a plumbing system within the building that you can come off any wall that you want to. You know, to service your equipment.
Yeah, very cool idea. I mean, if you're that size, then that makes perfect sense. Absolutely. So our Real Dream Workshop series. I love this workshop drive through. Thanks so much, Shawn. We're going to go across Ontario. We're going to look for cool things. If you have something cool in your shop, let me know. We want it to be part of this series. Either tweet me, email me, Peter Johnson at WheatPete, RealAgriculture.com, the Real Dream Workshop Series. We'll be back.